Hi, hello all, good evening.
गुड इवनिंग सर। हेलो
Good evening. Yeah.
हाय सर, गुड इवनिंग सर।
Good evening.
गुड इवनिंग।
Yeah. So let us start. Yesterday we have seen that aggregate functions. We started aggregate functions, right? So different aggregate functions and their variations we have seen, okay? Corresponding to the data types actually. So now let us continue with the another aggregate function. That is only one is remain, right? That is count aggregate function, okay? So let us try to understand what is that one, okay? So just for understanding purpose, we took some sample data here, that is student, roll number, name, marks. Okay. So as usually, try to answer every small question. Okay, right or wrong, don't bother. So here simple, to the count function, you can pass the star also. When you pass the star, what does it mean? It will return the total number of records. So just it is considering null values and duplicates. It is not going to bother at all actually. Okay. For example, if you return count star from students, so here you can see count star from students. What is the output it is going to return? Come on. What is the output it will return? Hello.
Student table.
Is it returning student table? Really? Come on, you see what is count star means? Count, see here what is their meaning? You see that total number of records by including null or duplicates if exist. So simply six records are there, so it is going to return six actually. So let us see practically here. Okay, so we are going to take a, so we have a EMP table, right? So let us take the EMP table here. So always check when you have multiple databases to which database you connected when you are writing a query actually. Okay. So here database is EFNDB actually mine. So now select star from EMP. Okay. So let us see the first of all data as usually. Keep always data in front of you, then write down the query. So that you will write always perfect query actually. So now here you can see select count star function I am taking from EMP. Okay. So what this query is going to return is required for us. Okay. So now you can see that. Let us keep like this. Yeah, run this one. So total number of records are 14. You can see here total 14 records. So that's what count is. So earlier there is no alias name. I'm just taking CNT. Now column name you are going to get, because for aggregate function it will not return any column name actually. So now if you see CNT coming as a column name, so total records are 14, that's all. So that's for the first part. So when you pass the star, it is simply returning total number of records, leave everything. That's what you have to answer. Okay. Now you can pass the column name also to the count function. So total number of records excluding null values it will return. So just try to answer by reading this statement, try to answer to this query. Come on. You have the marks
Right.
column here. See the data carefully, then try to answer it.
Six.
Five.
6, 5, both I am hearing. Yeah, okay.
Six.
6.
Six.
Read it once again. Returns total number of records excluding null values.
Excluding means five.
That's what you
Yeah,
have to
five.
see. Always don't be hurry to answer. Okay. Marks column, you pass it to the count function, marks column. So in that one of the value is null. So you have to exclude total five. But observe that there is a duplicate value. So duplicates it is considering as a one extra one value. So duplicates not eliminating, that have to keep in mind. So come here. So that's what the answer is, five, correct. So let us see here practically the same thing. So now you can see here the data For example, MGR column, let us take. Have a look here, MGR column. MGR column, if you see, MGR column, there is only one null value. Out of 14, one null value is there. So select count of MGR I am writing from EM. Okay. Now if you see this one, so 13 you are getting as output. That means this null value is excluded. So commission column also you can observe. In the commission column, how many values are there? Have observed that? Tell me how many values are there?
Four.
CNT for MGR. Now I am writing count of commission column. So this is CNT for commission column. So now when I run this query, okay, what it will return?
15 on 10.
For commission, how many record, how many number of records it will return? Number how much?
10.
Huh?
10.
10.
Sorry,
four.
That's what, carefully try to answer, okay? That's all, 4. See here, what is there in the commission column? In the commission column, all nulls are excluded. That's what the statement is saying. That's why we written it exclusively, okay? So all nulls are excluded. Zero, don't take zero as a null. Zero is different, null value is different, space is different, okay? So null means that value may be not applicable, may be not available. Whatever that you didn't inserted any data to that particular column in that row. So all nulls are excluded, so taken as count. Now, hope yesterday we discussed a distinct function. Okay. Basing on that, I am writing here one statement actually. So you need to write down the answer for that. So here, for example, first of all, if you see, select job only I am taking, select a job from EMP. So job column, if you take, these are all the different jobs. So I need actually clerk is one job type, salesman is one job type, manager is one type, 3, analyst and president. Total 5 job roles are there in this organization. So what we need in the output is that 5 we need. How many distinct jobs are there? How many number of distinct jobs are there? How many different jobs are there in your organization, if somebody asks, what is the query you are going to write down? Come on, try to understand. I am writing here the statement. Don't be hurry. Total number of jobs available, job roles, you can say, job roles available in organization. So to this, come on, try to write down the query and send it in the chat. Think carefully and then send it. Don't be hurry to answer. So two people responded. You are 100% wrong. Try it again. Right or wrong, try it. Basing on the knowledge what you have till now. Okay. Try to give the complete statement. Don't give half query. Okay, right, that's all. So now you can see simple. So if you take a job, okay, see here, for example, if I take a count of job from EMP. What I am getting the answer, you can see I am going to get total 14. You can see that. But that is not the answer. We need 5 actually. Suppose if I take select distinct job from EMP. See here carefully, you see here this query giving what? These are the 5 different jobs. We don't need what different job roles are there. I just need 5 different roles are there we need actually. So that's what here, very simple. Nothing is there. These two you need to combine. So first you try to identify different jobs. Yes, these are things. These things you try to count. So now this is in front of you output. Now then what you are going to do? 5. So you are telling 5. How you get that 5? After distinct applied on this, I counted actually. So that's all actually very simple thing. So here to the count function, you pass this output, distinct job output. Understand? Now you see both the outputs, both I am running. First one, if you see 5, you got it. That 5 you are counting with the count function, that's all. So nulls are eliminated, duplicates are eliminated, you can say, then 5 is returned. So you can see here, for example, if you take again entire data, okay, total MGRs, how many different managers are there? Total managers are how many? So same thing if I take, or if I take this one, okay, distinct underscore job, this one, then another one is MGR I'm taking, okay? So distinct, I'm giving alias name, MGR, okay? And names also, mostly you try to follow in real real-time also, if you are completely new, whatever names we are following. So you can see here, this one, different types, different managers are how many? What does it mean? Here you can see the entire data. See here, under MGR, 7902 is one manager, 7698 is one manager, like that, there are 6 managers. Nulls are excluded. So here you can see, especially this part, if you see, if I show you just, okay, that will not come here. If I show you just here, select distinct MGR from EMP. If I run and show you distinct MGR, only distinct MGR if I show you, it will consider null value also, see that. When you pass this one to the count function, nulls are excluded. That means that is what the statement here we given. So it returns total number of records by excluding null values actually. So you are passing this list, nulls are excluded, then remaining are counted. That's what this answer. Okay, so hope it is clear. So that's what here you can see, basing on the query, you try to answer. Come on, what is the output for this? Hello, what is the output?
4.
4. 4, that's all. So what is going to happen here? At least try to understand. This is the simple data, right? So on this simple data, when you apply distinct marks, so distinct marks is going to do what actually? It is going to return 80, 60, 90, 40, null, and 60 repeated, right? Distinct. So it is eliminated. So this is what the output of this part. Then when you go for count of this particular thing, whatever you have here, nulls are excluded, remaining is counted. So that's what 4. So with these two combination, what you can say, nulls excluded, duplicates are excluded. That's what actually total number of distinct, not null values, not null. That means nulls excluded, distinct, duplicates eliminated. So that's what sometimes you need to find out. total number. Count actually in this way also. Keep this in mind. Okay, that's what the count function. Hope it is clear. Any confusion, any doubts here in this overall discussion, count related? Okay. Yeah. So always, as I'm continuously saying, initial days I used to repeat the things. Feel free to ask if you have any doubts. Okay. So now let us see group by function, group by clause. Okay. Yeah. So come here. Let us try to understand. Once again, I am reminding you, group by is one of the very, very important one. Damn surely in your real time, you are going to use it. So try to understand, very easily try to understand. Okay. So just sit relaxly and just listen it. Okay. You will understand it very easily. Nothing is there, just in a real world, how you are doing different things. When you need to categorize the, when you need to categorize actually. So here, for example, the same data we took, only some columns we taken instead of 8 columns, we took 5 columns only. Okay. Now, group by meaning is what actually here is. Group by clause is used to combination with the select statement. Okay, fine. Arranging the same data into groups actually. That's all. Nothing is there. So when, see, in even in community also, some people grouped means they have the some common property. They have some common thing actually. So same thing here also, when you perform group by, then basing on what value they are going to become group. So column name you are going to mention. So here, for example, DEPT number, if you take as a group by, whoever have same department, those are one group actually, that's all. So all 10th department employees, so 10th department employees logically became one group. Three records are there, have a look. I'm just saying logically, that what is matter, you will understand later. Then 20th department employees, how many red lines are there? How many red things are there? Come on, tell me.
Five.
Five. So five. That means in the 20th department, there are 5 employees are there. That is what just group is happened. Just group is happened. That is also important. Then 30th department, how many employees are there?
Six.
Six employees.
Six.
Are. So think carefully. In a classroom, there are 60 students are there. And then faculty told that same grade students become one group. So people are not swapping their seats, but whoever A, they are becoming one group. Whoever B grade, they are becoming one group. C grade, one becoming one group, like that. That's all. So after the group is formed for some purpose. What you want to do on that group, that's what actually the actual discussion. So that is what actually here you see in the group by clause. In general, you will mention the column names. So that's what we are mentioning. In our case, we taken department number as a group by. So whoever have same number, same value, simply same data, whoever have, that will become one group. Done. Then in the select class, actual discussion is there. That is really matter. Okay. So that's what here you can see, group by class, DEPT number, then select statement. So, okay, you may, so with this statement, what happened is groups are formed. So what you want to do on those groups? That is what the next question. Some purpose is there to make the groups, right? So that's what aggregate functions coming to the picture. So in each group, I want to find out how many employees are there. So to find out number of employees, what is the corresponding function? Count function. So department wise number of employees, question is general question, department wise total number of employees I need actually that information. So that's what actually here, department number count star you are mentioning. So now earlier without group by count function we used, that time entire table count it is given, keep that in mind. Now along with the group by always, it will return per group that count. So in the 10th department, count is what? So three records are there. That's what, 1, 2, 3. So three is coming as an output. Year 5, year 6. So that's what you can see the output, 3, 5, and 6. Okay. So that is what the group by is going to do actually. On top of the group, what you want to do, always the question, I want to know number of employees in each department. So first in each department means first you perform the group, then in each group, you count total number of records, that means total number of employees. Then similarly, I want to find out total salaries spending per department. General statement. So per department you want to find out means first of all, you group them. That's what same thing will happen. Then in each department, you have a salary column. Is it or not? Three employees have a salary column. These three values summation only it is returning. These five values summation only it is returning. These five values summation only, six values summation only it will return. So per group, so that means per department, total salaries per month you are spending, it is returning, you can see. So try to understand what is happening on top of the group. Okay, so that's all. Like that, other aggregate functions. I want to find out average of each department salaries. So that's all. So function usage is simple, direct, but try to understand its inner meaning. So that's what actually minimum salary. So minimum salary, so department wise minimum salary is what? So in the 10th department, minimum salary is 1300, 20 is 1800, 30 is 950. So maximum salary per department is 5000 in 10, 3000 in 20, 2850 is 30 actually. So let us see the same thing practically. Let us try to understand. So take the entire data in front of us, select a star from EMP. So 14 records are in front of us. Let us have them. Yes. Now come here, select. Don't fill the select statement initially itself. Complete the remaining section. Then group by DEPT number. Then in the select statement, DEPT number, department wise you are performing the group. So the moment this line executed, what will happen is logically like this, you are going to have the records. Then in it will come to the select statement. Whoever asked one of the question, why not select statement, why it is going to the group by in the order of execution. So now you can understand. Okay. So count star, when I take C and T, what is happening after groups are formed logically, going to the each group and finding the number of records in each group. So that's what department wise it is returning the number of records. So have a look. So in the 10th department, 3 employees are there, 20th 5 employees, 30th 6 employees. Okay, so that's what the count function is doing. Now similarly, other functions, if you see, so sum of salaries, department wise total salaries, how much you are spending. So DEPT sal, sum of sal. Okay, so alias name, if I take, so similarly it will return total salary spending per department, it will show you. So now you can see here, select, I am just writing like this. For example, why you like this, if you see, select a count star, sorry, not this, so group by DEPT number. Okay, then here I am just taking, yeah, count star only. Okay, now if I run this query, what will happen, you can see this is what the output. Okay, anyhow, take it as a alias name also, well, that is not a matter. Now you can see this is the output. So how you will say this value is related to so and so department? So always recommended is what you have in the group by, In PySpark, by default, it will come. But in data, in SQL, you need to mention exclusively the column names. So what you have in the group by, you should mention in the select clause, actually. That's what I want to tell. Now, this is more meaningful than the earlier one. If I run this, you can see, you can tell that 6 is to 30th department. So like that, try to have whatever columns here you have here, actually, in the select clause. Okay. Now, one another thing, select, okay, from EMP group by DEPT number. Fine. DEPT number count to star, I am taking comma. Now I am taking just salary column here. Come on. One more thing here, for example, you see, this is a well-executed query, right? Without any errors, it is executed. Suppose somewhere I given comma, extra character. Have a look, there is a red color underline. That meaning is what actually? This is a syntactically not correct. This statement is syntactically not correct. So here comma you should not keep because there is no next column, right? So you have to leave like that. So immediately after comma removed, red color underline is gone. Even if you run this, whatever error it is showing here, you can see incorrect syntax near from. Even if you run, the same error it will show you. So the thing is, whenever you see red color underlines, this is a error. Something is there. Some main thing is syntax error. That's what I want to tell. Syntax error. Okay. Let it be this word. I will come back. Okay. Now, if I run this, so is there any syntax error here? Yes or no? In this statement.
Yes.
Whatever I selected in that, is there any syntax error?
No, sir.
No, there is no red color underline. Even if you run, okay, that part we will see, but there is no syntactic error. So let me run this. But it is throwing error. So you have different types of errors actually. Try to understand this. Use these words. So that's semantic error. Okay. Semantic means meaning. Okay. So nothing is there actually. First of all, try to understand. Department-wise total count, these two columns will return. And the salary column separately you have. So this column will return total 14 values. Here, three values. These two columns are returning three values. And this is returning 14 values. So there is no sync at all. There is no matching never possible. So that's why this is not a meaningful query actually. That's why there is a rule that you can see here, that rule. Suppose, let me take here sum of salary column. Okay. So sum of salary. Here I am taking MGR column to just to differentiate. Let us have comma. Even if you run this, same error it will generate. Have a look. Same error. Now, why we written like this is, now you see, department number column is there in this query, salary column is there, MGR column is there in the select clause. But at the MGR column, you are getting a problem. Have a look. Why? Actually is, the rule is, whatever columns you are using in the select clause, that column either exists in the group by clause. Yes, department number exists in the group by clause, or that is part of your aggregate function. That means inside of your aggregate function. But MGR neither exists in the group by clause nor part of the aggregate function. So that's what it is telling you, see, not contained either in aggregate function, MGR, yes, and not in the group by clause. The meaning is what I explained earlier. So it will return 14 values. These are returning 3 values. So you cannot map them actually, and not meaningful actually, data wise. So that's what this is calling a semantic error. When you are executing, that time you will encounter this type of errors. Though query wise syntactically it is correct, but semantically these are not correct. So the rule when you are using the column names, especially most people doing mistakes at here, okay? Columns what you are using in the select clause, you should be very careful. Okay, so that's what actually columns should be either present in the group by clause or part of the aggregate function. It should not exist directly in the select clause when you use group by clause in your statement. So these are the silly things people will ask in the interviews or in the written tests to test your knowledge. You no need to have millions of records data and to test your knowledge. This is more than enough to test how logically you are good, how much hands-on you have. Okay, so hope this is clear. Any confusion? In the group by class with a single group column in the group by we seen just now. Okay, and the main insight is column names usage in the select class. Okay, any doubts before going to see next part in this group by?
Can you add the manager column in the group by once?
Here?
Yeah.
That's what next discussion. Just wait. Okay.
Fine, fine.
Yeah. That's what this statement. Remember, we'll come back. Let us note down here somewhere. Anyhow, let us have MGR here. Let it have error. Okay. So I'm just pasting this. Where is the error not copied? Yeah. Okay, so this is the error we have. Yeah, any other doubts before moving to next in the group by clause itself? So always, again, I'm repeating, see here, very, very important. Please take it seriously. SQL side, even if you are a data engineer, definitely questions, 30-40% of the questions from the SQL side only. SQL, such an important thing, okay? So, and group by people will touch, joins people will touch, okay? And window functions people will touch, definitely in the interviews, okay? These are the main logical things to test whether a person is capable to do SQL side any queries or not. So, nothing is there actually, group by, take it, understand it very generally, groups. When you are performing group, there is a something common property. So here, whoever have same data under that particular column are going to become one group. So to understand simply, department number, if you take, whoever have same number, that means same data, that means same department is becoming one group. Entire record is part of that group. Keep that also in mind. Entire record, that means all columns data. For example, 10, if you take, is EMP number, e-name, job type, salary, and other columns also. All that part of the group by actually. So 10, these are the records, 20, these are the records, 30, these are the records. Then on top of that group, you formed the groups logically, but what you want to do that group, that's what aggregate functions you are using in the select clause. So on each group, I want to find out count, I can find out summation on some columns, I want to find out average, I can take min of e-name, whatever, you can experiment all other columns also. I took, just for understanding sake, salary column only in every aggregate function. So that's what the results here, okay? Now, in the group by class, you have the multiple columns actually. So then how it will behave, that's the matter now. So in the group by class, I'm taking the two columns actually. So let us come here. We can see the outputs directly there. Now, let us have the data in front of us, everything. Then how it will behave, you try to tell me. Now your part remaining. So these are the 14 records we have. Then see that from EMP, okay, group by, DEPT number, comma, job column I am taking. Whatever MGR also you can take, let it be. Job column I am taking. Then DEPT number, comma, job I am taking. Then count star only let us take, simple function. You need to understand when you have multiple columns in the group by clause. Yes, we have multiple columns. How that grouping is going to form, that is now matter. Now to answer this, we already discussed it actually. Come on, tell me how the groups are going to form. Come on, tell me. Or if you want here, let us try to take only DEPT number, comma, job column. Let us have only that data in front of you. See here. See here. Okay. Now tell me at least what is this output?
All the department numbers at one place and job at one place.
Okay. So that's good, right or wrong? You just tell me the answer. That is what I am expecting. Yeah.
The distinct count of combination of department number and job.
Okay.
It will take the department number because it
Department
was
number, job,
in
and number
group.
of the
It is in
job
group.
name.
So it is very simple. Now let us see. Nothing is there. So here you can see. Here nothing is there. See, group by means when you have multiple columns. See, that's what basic. Even yesterday also I mentioned that basic is really matter. Whoever have same value. Okay. Come on, you can see 20 clerk. One of you told correctly, but he mentioned some extra word. So it is becoming wrong. So 20 clerk. Here also 20 clerk. So whoever have this same combination is matter now. So grouping is, we see, all A grade boys in a section, in a classroom, all A grade boys, all A grade girls. So that means A grade boys becoming one group, A grade girls becoming one group, B grade boys is one group, B grades girls is one group. So two columns you used, one is grade, another one is gender. So whoever is same, so you are A grade boy, I am also A grade boy, so you and me becoming one group. A grade girl and another A grade girl becoming one group. So that's all. Who have the same data? That's what the basic we are telling. So 20 clerk, whoever is there, becoming one group. These two becoming one group. 30 salesmen, and here 30 salesmen. There are four records. These four records becoming one group. Same data, right? That's all. Simple. So that's all actually, you can see that. So always basic you apply, who have the same data became one group. Nothing is there. So here combination, same data. Earlier when one column is there, same data. Now combination wise, same data. That's why if you take individually, department number repetition is there. If you take job individually, repetition is there. But their computation combination never repeated. Like yesterday we discussed distinct. So 20 analysts, two records are there. Here 30 salesmen, so four records are there. 20 clerk, two records are there. Remaining one record. So that's what very important in this case when you have multiple columns in the group by clause. Is it clear?
Just a second.
Yes.
Like I can see that the job was all at the sorted in single query, like of the clerks at the place, manager at the place, but not the department number. Why?
Not the.
Department number.
Come again, your question.
I'm asking that clerk or manager, those are at one after other, right? But not the
No.
department number.
See, try to understand the meaning of the group by when you have multiple columns is what? What is your understanding? Come on, tell me.
It will sort by all the
No,
groups,
no,
all.
no sorting, no sorting. Okay.
Okay.
whoever have same value. Sorting is not at all introduced. The sorting is not going to work here.
Okay.
Their combination, you take it. So 10, okay, let us take entire, let us take both the data in front of you. I will tell you. Okay. Come on. First query is giving what? Just department number and job, entire 14
Yeah.
things. So for example, you are telling that 10 clerk, if you take this combination. So 10 clerk combination, if you see here, one combination is there, 14th.
Yeah.
Okay. So there is only one record actually. That combination is have only one record. So that's what count is one. Okay. That's what here count is one. For example, 20 clerk, if you take. So 20 clerk, there is one record here, one record here, and here 20 clerk, one more record. Two records are there. That means two employees are there in the 20th department working as a clerk. Is it or not? So
Yeah.
that's what the count two. So combination, whoever have same. That's what I'm saying. A grade boy, all boys in A grade becoming one group. So two columns included, gender and grade. Yes or no?
Yeah.
So that's what actually. So in the group by, when you have multiple columns, take their combination as group actually. Whoever have same combination becoming one group.
Okay.
Clear or not? Clearly.
Yeah.
Okay, any other doubts? Others?
No.
This is really matter. Why I'm stressing? It may take 10-15 minutes extra, but it is going to useful throughout your data domain career. That may be data engineer, database developer, or whoever. Because damn sure questions in the interview. In real time, extensively you will use these things. Okay. Almost every day you will touch for this and that. Okay? Try to understand meaningfully. Yeah. So that's what here also, department number and job. So you can see the how the output, same thing what we see now. Okay. And other things, sum of salaries. So now here two employees are there. Two employees summation you will get actually 1900. So you can see that here. For example, whoever have still doubt, clerk 20. So here 20 clerk and 20 clerk. So summation here 800, here 1100, total 1900. So because though both of them have same data, 20 clerk, their salaries only you sum. Simply you can see 20 analyst. So 20 analyst 3000. Here also 20 analyst 3000. That means Ford and Scott working in the 20th department as a analyst. Their so total summation of salaries is 6000. That's what. So like that remaining you can cross check. Remaining is one means one only. So 10 manager. So you can see 10 manager 2450. Only one employee. So that will become total summation. So like that average you can see. So 1900 by 2, 950. So 6000 by 2, 3000, like that. Okay. So minimum salary in that combination, maximum salary in that combination. That's what actually group by clause in all the directions. Okay. So any confusion overall in this part also? Really matters. Always recommendation is for you is please try to do the hands-on. That is really matter. So though you understood, but still you will understand real depth, real meaning when you do on your own. Okay? Yeah. Any doubts here in this discussion?
No,
Can we say that the group by is alternate to distinct also, right?
not at all. Distinct is not forming any groups. Distinct is just telling that different values under one column or multiple columns. That's all. But on top of these groups, you are able to do different aggregations. Yes or no? Count, sum, all these things.
Yeah.
And in future, you are going to see window functions. That is really, really very good subject and doing many things in that. Okay.
Okay. So this group I will eliminate the duplicates also.
It is not eliminating the group duplicates. So when
Okay.
you group the all A grade students, are you eliminating remaining all A grade students? Only one A grade student you are taking?
No, no.
Group is different, distinct is different. Understand?
Okay.
Simply, how many grades are there in your section? A grade, B grade, C grade, D grade, E grade. Five grades are there. That's all distinct is saying.
Okay.
Group grade wise means all A grade students sitting at one place. There are 10 students, assume A grade. So 10 students exist physically. That's all. You didn't eliminate 9 students. Only one student you didn't take in. All 10 exist. Get the
Okay.
clarity or not?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Don't confuse. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask. Don't worry about others. It is your doubt, your part. Yeah. So, on top of this, very easily you can understand nothing is there. That is having clause. So, that is completely related to the group by class. So come on, tell me what we discussed in the day two about the having clause. What is actually having is doing? I given some sentence.
Having using only while summing or aggregation functions.
No, what is the purpose of having?
Filter.
A set of values as input and given one value as output.
No, no. That is aggregation.
Groups.
Someone used one word, but you can extend that word.
Filter.
Filtering
having
the columns.
Filtering.
Filtering the columns.
Having used for a aggregate. Having work on your aggregation function. Where not
okay. Further, you need to tell having. So simple. Select clause
having
is filtering the columns. Select clause is for filtering the columns. Where clause we not yet discussed, let it be. Having clause is for filtering the groups. Okay? Simple. What we discussed actually, in 10th department, 3 records you got when you perform group by department number. In 20th department, 5 groups, 5 records you have. 30th department, 6 records you have. Understand, observe my sentence very carefully. Okay. Suppose 3 employees here, 4 employees here, 5 employees here, 6 employees here. That is what count star is giving. So you can see here. For example, if I write like this, what you are getting, this is what the output. Have a look. Okay. For this query, this is the output. That means 10th department 3, 20th department 5, 30th department 6. Take like this. Now, this is the just group by is doing, whatever we discussed till now. I don't need all these departments. I need the departments which have more than 4 employees. So to tell which department have more than 4 employees, first you have to perform group by and summation count. That is the first thing. Yes, done. This is the result. On this result, 3 greater than 4, no, this record not coming. 5 greater than 4, yes, this record is coming in the output. 6 greater than 4, yes, this record is coming in output. So that is what filtering the groups actually. This is the groups result and this is the having result. So groups are formed as usually, and you are further filtering the groups by applying some condition. So that's what the output. This is group by output and this is having out. Try to understand. So that's what saying that it is filtering the groups further. So the statement is what? Give the departments who have more than four employees. Give me the departments who are spending the total salary more than 5,000 rupees. Department wise, total salaries you have who have more than 5,000 actually. So let us see that practically here, whatever we discussed. So now we are going to see having clause. Okay. Select star from EMP. Total data keep always in front of you. Now in this from EMP group by department number we are taking. Then what we are doing here is department number. Then sum of salary, for example, take directly first. So sum of salary, if you see, this is what. So now in this query, having clause we are extending, having, okay, sum of sal greater than, for example, here 8750, like this we have. Which department total spending salaries more than 9,000? I want those departments in the output. So what will happen? 10th department total, three employees are there. Three employees total summation itself 8750. So that is not more than 9,000. So 10th department will not come in the output. So what you filtered, groups you filtered. So 10 will not come, these two will come. So you can see both the outputs. So first output is without having. Second output is with having. Understand? So having clause is for filtering the groups. Any confusion here? So that is what the having clause here it is saying.
We can do the same thing by using the where condition also, right?
No, it's not possible. You can try some aggregate functions you cannot use in where clause. You can try that. Okay, in where clause, I will tell those insights. Okay.
Okay.
Where is not yet done, but still your doubt is valid, but you cannot, because you can tell the reason also. Now you can tell reason. Where clause is executing before group by itself, is it or not?
Yeah.
That's what we discussed, airdrop evolution. So
Thanks.
you will get that clarity once where is done. But in where clause, you cannot use directly the aggregate functions. Okay?
Okay.
Any doubt here? That's what having simply. Okay? So, whoever. Don't have EMP table. How many of you don't have EMP table? Come on. All of you got the EMP table script right and executed in your SSMS.
Yes.
Yeah. Because today many people
Sir, I
ask,
don't have.
yeah. So what I am doing is I am just sending you again. So have a look here. Just 1 minute. So I am pasting this entire script in the chat. Okay. Please take this script and then execute in your SQL server. Okay. But still, if you have any doubts, you can tell me. I will send it to you. Okay. Okay, it is a lengthy one. It's not coming directly. No problem. You just ping me personally. Hope all of you have my number. If you don't have, still, this is my number. Okay. Or you can call to this number. Okay, so you can call or WhatsApp to this number. You can call to this number. Okay, so today we have seen that clearly what is the aggregate functions completed, group by and having. Okay, so the on top of this, tomorrow we will see, first of all, here if you see, we are going to get the clarity that this hierarchy, actually server hierarchy. Okay, this server hierarchy we are going to see. On top of that, what we are going to see, hierarchy, and then we will try to create Azure SQL Server in Azure Cloud. Actually, very, very, very important. It is like anything, and in your real time also, this is matter for you. Okay. So, and then we will see the where class if you have a time, or we will see in the next class. Okay. And especially why I'm creating this particular service in the Azure Cloud now itself is, some people may not have a personal laptop to practice this SQL. So those people can create account in the Azure, and then you can practice your SQL Server actually. Okay. Or whatever reason, anyhow, I need to discuss in next week, starting itself. Okay, when the data factory is started, before data factory itself, I need to discuss. So tomorrow, anyhow, it is a Friday, so better I will discuss this hierarchy and then creating this one, because this is a lengthy one and you need to understand every minor step in your real time. Exactly same thing you are going to understand doing actually. Okay, so many people don't know some intermediate steps, so they will struggle. So that's why we are trying to discuss everything, how you will create, how you will connect to your local SSMS. You can operate your cloud SQL server from this SSMS itself. Then all those things and IP rules, how you'll firewall settings, all those things we are going to see. Okay, that is tomorrow's agenda. So hope that is clear what we discussed it till now. Yeah. So let us meet tomorrow. Use the same link. Okay. Feel free if you have any doubts. Okay. Whoever taken
Regarding,
permission. Yeah.
sir, like somewhere we use like select star, or somewhere like I see some queries where we used select one. So can you tell me the what is the meaning of select one? Like,
Is it one? Is it this or this one?
Yes, select
Just
one.
to select one?
No, like with the table name.
Come on, what you are going to get the output? Any expectation? Anything? Can anybody tell?
Maybe
First
data
top
or
row.
first column.
So I will tell you simple. See, nothing is there. Select star from EMP. So let us take first of all EMP data. Okay. Tell me what I am answering. Just pinpointly answer it. How many records it returned?
All records.
14.
14
Records.
records.
First number 14. 14. Keep that in mind. In EMP table, how many records are there?
14.
14.
14.
Have a look.
Yes.
How many ones returned?
14.
14.
14. If you have any confusion, come here. Select star comma one. Now I am running this. Have a look. See the last column, one. So how many rows you have in that table already? If you want to generate default value, so like this you can do sometimes. Okay. Is it clear? Sometimes if you want to make this as a default value, and this you will see in the merging course, in the data modeling, slowly changing dimension in model 2, type 2, you are going to see this kind of discussion actually. Okay. Hello? Whoever asked, is it clear? So one is just
Yes, sir,
giving.
it is clear. Like I have one query, sir. Can you check and like I
Okay,
am
you
pasting
submit
that
me
query in the
the
chat.
WhatsApp.
Okay, sir.
You
Yeah,
send
ठीक
in the chat.
No, I didn't send it in chat.
Okay.
Let me send.
See, these queries basing on their situation, people.
Here,
Okay.
I have sent it that like if here we, like what the use of one like I'm
Okay,
trying
this is nothing, man, nothing there.
like
So here one
exactly.
is not matter. What is his query is, let me take it this one to the to here. See, this query is actually, this is not related to the select one. The main subject here is, okay,
Huh, like
main
main
thing
subject is
exist.
transferring data from one table to another
Simple. Wait,
table
wait,
on the
just
basis of primary.
wait, wait, nothing is there. See here, table, you will see in future actually. I may not discuss exist, okay, but you can understand this is called a subquery. And in the subqueries also, this concept is called correlated subqueries. Okay. First of all, subquery means you can see query within the query. That's what subquery concept, normal thing, subset. Okay. In the select statement, you have another select. That means subquery. Correlated means core. Wait, wait, wait. Correlated means you can see outer query, outer table A, inner table B. Have a look. Okay. Outer table, inner table, each record wise comparison is happening. Each record wise comparison is happening. That's called correlated. Normal subquery is different. Correlated subquery is different. Suppose what is one here, you don't need any data. You should not place any column name so that if you place the column name, it will increase the size of the output of your query actually. Just by placing minimal number one, if you have some output here, that means if you have at least one one here, at least one one here, or simply some output if you have, that means exist something. That means what record you have in the A, that record is coming in the output. If you do, if this query, nothing is selected, not exist, nothing is exist inside. So whatever record correspondingly you are comparing here with B here, that record is not coming in the output. So at a high level, I can give this much. Okay. So this is very interesting topic. Exist, not exist. Simple. Exist inside subquery. If something exists, outside query record is coming in the output. Not exist, nothing exists inside query, then that particular record is not coming in the output. That's all. Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir, got it now. No problem. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So hope it is clear. Any other doubts? Feel free. Always you are welcome. Okay. Yeah. Okay, then I'm stopping here. If you don't have any doubts, let us meet tomorrow, same time. Use the same link. Okay. Thank you. Thank you all. Good night.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good news.
Thank you.